this video is kind of interesting. I will say so myself. Tonight's video is called God Talks to Me. The first thought that came to mind whenever I came up with that idea was, okay, people are gonna be like, this girl is off her rocker. And I sat there with it and I'm like, do I really want to talk about this topic? I don't know. And then I think to myself, okay, well, can it help anyone if I do talk about this topic? And the answer was yes. So because the answer is yes, I trust my intuition and I go with the flow about it. And then I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna do it, right? The reason why I wanted to make this video is because this is a part of my life now and it's like a regular thing. This started like a year ago where I hit my lowest point, my rock bottom. You know the vibes. I went to therapy. Therapy did not do it for me. I felt like, wow, something that's supposed to help people is not helping me. That thought was kind of frustrating and like disappointing. I got into tarot and like basically figuring out self-soothing and figuring out how to like understand my own psyche and my own self and whatever's inside without having a professional to like aid me on that journey. You start to learn to trust these signs and you start to see them as less foreign, because at first you're like, okay, where are these coming from? Because they're so specific and so like real and true to me in my life that there's no way that this is just a coincidence. That's how you figure out that God is starting to talk to you. The whole point of me talking about all this stuff and rambling on about all of this is that one day these signs won't be scary, they won't be intimidating, they'll become like comfortable and it'll be like you're at home to get these signs and synchronicities and things like that, which is talking to God. And I used to, see, I'm feeling myself talking about it as signs and synchronicities, but that's like a very detached way of looking at God talking to you. Whenever I see these signs, I don't have to verbally speak them out loud all the time or obsessively journal them down and like document them, because now I just live them and I'm welcoming and I accept it. So I'm accepting God talking to me now. And I'm able to sit back and I'm able to continue to let God talk to me, and I continue to let God's voice and presence into my life and into my heart. So now this stuff is just part of me. This is what you're doing to yourself. This is how your life is turning out. Are you okay with this? Do you like this? Do you like where you're at? Do you like the way that you are? Do you like the way that you are with other people or the way other people are with you? And if you have problems with these types of things, then you know like divine intervention is happening. God is wanting you to like course correct and do something different. These things, these words, these ways that God talks to you and he shows you that he's there. I have an example of this, but I'm gonna walk you guys through an entire night of signs and synchronicities and how they're aligning with each other with evidence. So it's gonna be like a case file of God talking to me, and I'm gonna show you our receipts, girl. I took pictures and videos of everything except for a few details. I'll just fill them in because I don't want it to be like just shoving this in your face. Like, look guys, like look at all the different ways that I can sit here and analyze. To me, it's not even analyzing. It's just become natural for me to observe these things, mentally take note of it, process it, boop, 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 woohoo. And then it goes through my heart, through my head, everything, talks to my intuition about it, and then it spits back out and then I move on. Because if I stay attached to anything for too long, then it takes me off my path, essentially, is what I'm trying to say. You listening to yourself and your intuition is staying on your path. You can, you know, consume yourself with other people and what they're up to and what's going on in their mind and all this different stuff, but if your primary focus isn't yourself, then you're not going to be able to do this, and you're not going to be able to like hear God correctly, properly, or period, like at all. By you being in touch with yourself, you open up this portal and this gate of like knowledge and information and stuff that God can like bring into you. And those are the answers. And the secret to life and this whole thing is to listen. You see it in front of you in the real world because God wants you to see it in the real world in front of you, because then you can believe it. Back in the day, I didn't believe in any of this stuff. I kept denying it. I kept pushing it away. I kept putting it in a box. That is not what I wanted to see or deal with. I had an ego. I had my whole mind, body, soul, everything was like me. me mode, just me. And now it's me plus God, but God's the bigger emphasis. And that's why I see and feel all these things happening around me. It's like the puzzle piece is coming together. Divine timing is happening and things are going in my favor. It's like I don't even have to try. It's just happening because I've learned by practice, through spiritual practice and discipline, how to operate my life in the best way and to be the driver in my own life. It's kind of like you have a little ping, you have a little, whatever you call it, device in your ear, and God is talking to you through it. It just becomes an interwoven part of who you are. It doesn't feel invasive like a parasite because God's love and the universe and everything, it's pure and it's genuine, it's real. And it is not there to steer you in the wrong direction. And that's why you can trust it. And the thing is, the enemy, the devil, whatever you want to say, that darker energy doesn't want you to like have faith in anything. That energy wants you to suffer. That's its job. And then God's job and the universe's job is to take you away from that and to pull you into the light. And to go up into a higher vibrational place where you can create anything you want with your life, with yourself, with people around you. You can make anything you want of yourself, and you can completely turn your life around and have a complete transformation, a complete death and transformation. Phoenix rising from the ashes. God and the universe give you this possibility, and you may like ask yourself, well, how do I know like what this purpose is and what this big plan is? Like, oh my God. You are a form of God, and you are a byproduct of the universe. You are the universe, as these Pinterest quotes say. The thing about these Pinterest quotes is they seem cheesy, and they seem like, oh my gosh, like, really? But it's truth, and it's simplified, and they're trying to make it accessible to people through a Pinterest quote. Like, okay, here's what's supposed to inspire you, but that is not what's actually inspiring you. What should be inspiring you is yourself and God and the conversations that you guys have, the internal dialogue that you, God, the universe have together to create something. For example, on this little tangent, we have this poodle, and I'm going to put all of these on the screen right here so that we can talk about these together. First picture I'm looking at, I'm sitting outside on my front porch and I see this tree. Every single night I go outside on the porch, I see this tree. And to me, on the left side, it's like this little circular half circle arch. And to me, that's like the back of a dog. And this little poof in the middle, there's like three like humps on the tree. Middle one is like the dog's neck. Then the top part is like this top part of its head. I have been wanting a poodle so bad. Like, I think about poodles all the time. The thing about the poodles is they don't stink like normal dogs do. Like, they don't have the wet dog smell. They're extremely intelligent and they have kind of like their own independence to them. Just like love the poodle demeanor. Standard poodle, not toy, miniature, none of that. Just the standard guy. And I think I want a black poodle. And I had this voice in my head, and that is what God is saying, is the voice in my head, right? And like the devil and angel on your shoulder. So what I've done for myself is I've conquered the evil. So I no longer have the devil on the shoulder. I don't deal with that. I used to, but I don't anymore. So now the only voice I hear is, that gave me chills, like, oh my God. The only voice I hear is the good side, the angels, God, universe. All that is good is all I hear. That's it. So now if any negative or anything comes my way, it's an instinct to not see. I'm grabbing the pin as an instinct. It is an instinct to not want to listen to that voice at first. Then over time, as you get used to it, you grow into it. It's just like growing up. You grow into your skin, you grow into your, you know, full form and your full size of who you're supposed to be, and you're maturing. So it's just like in you know, your physical body, you're spiritually maturing as well. As you spiritually mature, this challenge of having to like fight the negativity and inner demons and the demons and all this stuff, you don't have to do it anymore because you already trained and you already upgraded yourself, so you no longer have to be at that stage. So one example is this police badge rank. I was just pondering on this thought, like, because I have a friend who is in police academy or was in police academy, I believe. Forgive me if you're watching this and I am not exact about it. I was just assuming, so my apologies. But, you know, like police academy training and wanting to raise ranks, but in a very significant way. And that's not my place to share his story or anything like that. But he has some pretty amazing goals, huge goals, and it's really admirable to see. As you trust this new spiritual voice and this new, like, settling into who you are as a spiritual human being, you upgrade constantly. And there will be different tests and evaluations in life, just like in, I'm sure, police academy or any other thing that has a rank. You can't just start at the top. You unfortunately, or fortunately, however you want to look at it. See, the unfortunately is like the negative voice. But now I can acknowledge, okay, that's not my true heart talking. That is just the negative voice that I can like flick away very easily now. And then you can focus on like the positive part of it. And as you start to focus on the positive, then you start to manifest a different story and a different like track or path in your life. Anyways, to like confirm these signs and these things that God is saying to me, he showed me Brooklyn Nine-Nine on TV, which is a police force. So I just was catching up with this police friend, and then I was watching Brooklyn Nine-Nine, which is a police TV show. Oh yeah, and in Private Practice, Addison is dating a cop. Then he upgraded to SWAT team. The next thing I'm going to show you guys is this commercial. It has a really good message in it. It's this dude singing, I need to Shazam it and figure out the song. And if I can, I'll include it. But listen to this. I still believe in you and me, because every night I go to sleep, I can see it like a movie in my dreams, put my face in the dirt on the ground, still I raise up to take back the crown. Yes, you can break my body, but you can't lock the soul of a man down. So basically, like, life is beating him down over and over. Things are happening, things aren't going his way. And that's like the dark side trying to like take your dreams away from you and for you to be a lost soul that doesn't have a direction or purpose in their life. Follow your dreams, not your addictions. How are we gonna follow our dreams locked in a prison? They tried to swallow me whole, God be my witness, deprive me out of my dreams, but I'm relentless. I want the money, ain't never want attention, so I don't pay attention to comments and all the mentions, cause they ain't seen my vision. So with this little section, follow your dreams, not your addictions, like have a goal in sight and don't stay down for too long. How are we gonna follow our dreams locked in a prison? So it's a metaphorical prison, a mental prison. Of you staying in your old thought patterns and beliefs and not letting yourself change. Like, you're stuck, right? You're stuck in a mental prison. But the thing is, you have the key. You always have the key, but you don't know how to use it without God's help, essentially. So that's what these signs and things like that are for me, is like direction. And I was thinking of the analogy like breadcrumbing, and how breadcrumbing can be a negative phrase, but it actually is a positive thing. Like in real life, like breadcrumbing, the purpose of breadcrumbing is to leave a trail so that you can find your way back home. But now people say breadcrumbing can be giving someone a little tiny bit and not what they deserve. But if you flip it on the happier side, the positive side, the non-devil on your shoulder side, then breadcrumbing is actually a good thing because it's leading you home back to yourself. So God leaves these little breadcrumbs here and there for you so that you can look at them. In this whole like spiritual training process where it's like just you, it's kind of like a retreat. My hands look so orange. That's funny. He's giving you these little hints and tips and little tricks and like all these different things through your intuition that you're intended and you're supposed to be like listening to. If you're not listening, then you don't get the good breadcrumbs that God's trying to give you so that you can figure out your way, find your path, and find yourself. So the next one is, and don't pay attention to the comments and the mentions, meaning don't pay attention to what other people think, what other people have to say, because your voice is the only voice that matters in addition to God's, and you can respect what your friends and family think or say, but at the end of the day, you're an independent human being, and it's your decision to live your life how you want to live it. Ain't nobody gonna tell you how to live your life, sister, sir, man, period. Amen. In the school of failure, we present perfect attendance. You're used to the dark, is what this lyric is saying. You're used to the dark, you're used to being beat down, you're used to not having things go your way, you're used to life not being in your favor, and you're probably used to feeling a little bit out of control of like things going on in your life. Like you no longer have a say, because if you had a say and you wanted it to be better, then it would just be better. But the thing I'm learning is it takes work. You can't just have anything. You have to like understand it fully, understand why you want it, why you like it, why you appreciate it, or why you don't. You're just supposed to learn from like everything in life. It seems like a lot of work at first, but once you actually hop into it and get to it, it's not that big of a deal. And it's actually easy, and it's easier, and you're more at peace, and you feel more like in tune and like just comfortable, and but still passionate and motivated about life. Like it's crazy. And then the next thing that came on my TV was this Target commercial.
Join in and game on. Just download the Target app and try it today.
Join in and game on. So you can hop on this train of God train, or you don't have to, but you're going to be more lost on the non-God train. And if you're not aware and listening and present and, you know, seeing these things in the world around you, like I maybe would have never even thought to look at the trees a couple years ago. But now, like, I just notice everything, and there's no more like hiding. Like, people can't hide. I can't hide from myself. Like, everything is just truth to me. Like, I see it, and I see a lie, and I see the truth, and it's like a black and white way to live in a sense, but it's also not. Like, there's way more like nuances and complexities to life than that. But that's that. And the next thing is the next commercial that comes on. First of all, there's a beautiful rainbow on this like freeze frame right here. And I actually just revamped my Culture Evolution and my Mads ASMR Haven banner thingy, and it's a rainbow. I was just watching this like TikTok girl. I don't watch TikTok, but this video popped up on YouTube that said why I quit TikTok. And I was interested because I feel like so many like young kids now like love TikTok. So I'm like, why did this person choose to not? I don't know. I was just interested. She had this beautiful like rainbow makeup look. She was in a dark place, like hurting. And she said she couldn't be in this like toxic environment anymore. She needed more positive people. In this video, you can really feel her energy, and you can tell her pain and her hurting. But you can see, because she's aware and she's conscious of all this stuff, it's not like too late for her. Me watching this video of her, it was a mirror of my old self, and it really like hit me home in a certain way. Like I had to respond to her, and I did like 2 fat paragraphs just telling her, oh, this is exactly like what I went through, and I feel you and I understand you, but like it does get better. I thought I would never be happy too, and I thought I would never like enjoy my life and love who I am, but I do. So it just shows you like with time and with patience and understanding and, you know, forgiving yourself, like you're able to move forward. But you have to be the person to decide to take that walk and to take that journey. Basically, it's an apple orchard commercial, and I'm eating apples, and then at the end of this commercial, it's 2 cookies, and the commercial is about 2 like a $2 deal for two items, and I intentionally chose two cookies, like, as my snack tonight. And then in my TV show that I'm watching, Brooklyn Nine-Nine, he's eating a chocolate chip, like, protein bar, granola bar, something like that, and I was choosing between a chocolate chip granola bar and this chocolate chip cookie. So the fact that the TV is, like, reflecting back to me, like, my actual world, that's like another way like God is talking to me, right? And then in the very last scene, she's sitting on her little like wooden counter table thing. There's hella plants in the back, and I was just thinking today, like, I really want to buy a bunch of plants. Like, I want some plants, not a bunch, but I just want one plant, and I want to learn about it and take care of it and whatever, like, just for fun, just to change it up in my life. Get this catalog in the mail, and it has plants on it. It's like all these different rooms have a bunch of beautiful styled like plants, and it looks so cozy. It's just this whole like whirlwind of everything. And then I was like scooping my peanut butter. Normally I don't eat it out of the spoon, I like put it on the plate, but I didn't feel like having a dirty plate, so I just, you know, took a little bit off the spoon. And then I looked at it, I lifted it up, and it immediately looked like a heart. I'm like, whoa, okay. So all these messages tonight, like, love ties into it somehow. Like, I need to trust love, and I need to trust my heart and know that there's only love out there for me right now to receive, any form that that is. And then I'm looking at the top of this Jif peanut butter. It says no need to stir. Like, there's no need to do anything else about it. Like, you just sit, relax, it's already done for you. You know, the plan's out there, your destiny's out there, and you're just kind of walking the path and doing the motions by listening to your heart, listening to your passions, and always following and chasing whatever goals and dreams you have, even if it's just day-to-day type stuff. Like, you just listen to yourself. And that's me trusting my heart. So the peanut butter on the little apple slice says that. It's emphasizing that point. And next.
Leap into the unknown. Maybe a better question is, what are you waiting for? Pacifico is brewed for those who follow their own path. That's living life anchors up.
Living life on your own path. And then said anchors up, and at the bottom it says Chicago, Illinois, which is where I want to move sometime after I graduate. Then the anchors up thing, I didn't bring my cup up here on purpose. Like, I didn't want to have to carry up so much stuff up the stairs, but I should have, because if I would have brought it up here, I would have had it in my hand to show you. Anchors up, it was a cup with an anchor on it, and I have a shit ton of cups in my cabinet, like, but I felt drawn to the anchor cup tonight. So that's God talking to me. God's like indirectly just embedded and woven into my being and my existence, because like that's destiny taking its course. So it's like right place, right time type of stuff. And if you're not in the right place at the right time and you're not listening to yourself, then you're gonna miss all these opportunities. But if you are present and you do listen and you do take things in and you receive good energies and you trust it, then only good things can happen. So it's literally just about mindset, and it sounds crazy, but like that's just the truth, honestly. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. I know it's super long and it's just another one of my night casts, so I hope you don't mind. God talks to me. I love you guys so much, and I will talk to you in my next one. Bye. Can I give you more? Can I give you more, child? Can I give you more? I will give you everything, my child. Just waiting for the timing. Oh, now.